You need a cut, and soon you will be able to get one. The governor announcing today that salons and barbershops can open on May 15th.
I'm sure that that's good news for a lot of people who've been looking to get back, particularly in regard to their hair. I know I've heard a lot about that.
Nail salons and day spas also included in this opening. The state shut down beauty and barbershops almost 2 months ago, but News 5 has uncovered a surge of complaints alleging some never closed. Five on Your Side investigator Sarah Buttison tells us what's being done to stop shops failing to follow the rules.
I felt like it was a storm coming, and it was just a matter of time that it would come here and hit us pretty hard, which it did.
So, 3 days before Governor Mike DeWine issued the order to close because of the coronavirus, Dino Palmieri shut down all 10 of his Northeast Ohio hair salon and spas.
Oh, it's extremely hard because the rent doesn't go away, the utility don't go away, so the whole thing is still there.
Pressures like that may explain this. We found a surge in complaints to the Ohio State Cosmetology and Barber Board since Governor Mike DeWine ordered barbershops, beauty salons, and tattoo parlors to close March 18th. 168 in total, almost all alleging the same thing. Businesses ordered to shut down are still open.
We try to take each complaint as it comes in and evaluate it on its merit.
Tanya Burford is the director of environmental health for Summit County. They have received about 50 complaints about beauty supply stores and salons. She says it's just too dangerous for salons to be open now, so her staff checks out each complaint.
But if we are implementing these other processes and other things that require that close personal contact, that we do it at the right time and we do it in the right way.
We randomly selected businesses around Northeast Ohio that received complaints to see if they're open.
This is Sarah with News 5. I was wondering why someone called to complain that you were still open in violation of the governor's shutdown order.
A man who said he's an employee at a Westlake business told me he has no idea why someone called to complain. He says he's only at the business to take calls from clients.
So you're not open at this time?
A woman who answered the phone at a different shop in East Cleveland also told me she didn't violate the order and was just hanging out at her business when police stopped by last month. No one picked up at the other businesses we tried, so then we did random spot checks at businesses with complaints. All appeared to be shut down.
Most of the time, we got compliance.
Cuyahoga Environmental Health Supervisor Jerry Scott says only a handful of the county's more than 1,000 coronavirus-related complaints have involved salons and barbershops. And he says most owners quickly agreed to shut down when his staff called them out.
Luckily, we have the capacity to follow up on these. So I think, you know, there is some personal responsibilities of the operators to take it upon themselves to do the right thing. And if not, that's what we're here for.
People can wait to get their hair done. It's not an urgency. They have no place to go.
Dino is a member of Governor DeWine's advisory group, creating recommendations on how salons can safely reopen. Well, he's willing to wait until those plans are in place. He understands why so many clients are in a rush to return.
You can be in a pajama at home or you can be with a casual clothing, but if your hair don't look good, you don't feel good.
Isn't that the truth? And again, Governor DeWine has said salons and other personal care businesses can reopen next Friday. In the meantime, health officials tell me that they will continue to issue verbal warnings to businesses that have remained open. Repeat violators could face a second-degree misdemeanor charge and the threat of losing their license. I'm 5 on Your Side investigator Sarah Buttison.